Hi, this is Dr. Damon Miller, your Organic MD.
And this is Carlisle Koash. Welcome to the Organic MD videocast. This is another in our series on different subjects. This particular series is going to be on retinitis pigmentosa.
And we're going to be talking first about some of the genetics of RP, and we're going to be retinitis pigmentosa. And we're going to then move, the next talk will be about some of the research that's being done for retinitis pigmentosa. And the final of the three talks is going to be about what we know about the treatment of retinitis pigmentosa. So I just want to start, you know, it's important to understand these, there is a genetic underpinning to these diseases, meaning that these diseases run in families. And in most people who actually are diagnosed, if you go looking, you will find an abnormal gene. Now, don't get me wrong, I don't recommend that everybody run out and get genetic testing. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But there is a gene that's abnormal. And the what's interesting, you know, there are whole medical journals devoted to the study of the genetics of ophthalmologic disease. One that's called Ophthalmologic Genetics, and they did an article some years ago, but it was talking about genetics uniting what ophthalmologists divide. You know, ophthalmologists base their diagnosis on, you know, what the eye looks like, what the retina looks like. You know, are you losing central vision like you would see in macular degeneration, or are you losing peripheral vision? That's what you'd see in retinitis pigmentosa. Do you have abnormalities in an electroretinogram? It's a test that's done that helps diagnose retinitis pigmentosa and differentiate it from other diseases because you have loss of electrical activity. But so these diseases, in a way, look different. They clinically appear different, but they all have the same gene, same gene that has abnormalities, maybe at different places. And so why is it that you have one gene that can have these abnormalities, and in one person it looks like one disease, and in another person it looks like another disease? And nobody really understands that at all. Why is it that one person would have a genetic abnormality and it shows up when they're 5 years old, and another person has a very similar abnormality and it shows up when they're 70? So there are all kinds of things that go into these genes, whether your body expresses it or not, when it expresses it. The story isn't just, do you have a gene or not? And that's one of the reasons why I don't recommend that people run out and get these genetic tests. It just promotes a lot of fear, and it doesn't tell you really what's going to happen to you. So, you know, one of the, GraceHalloran, who really developed a lot of the work that we still are using today, she herself had retinitis pigmentosa, and her son was born, and from a very, very early age, you could tell by looking at his eye that he was going to have the family disease and have it bad. And it was really because of him and trying to help him that's what lit the fire under Grace to try and find things to do for this disease. And thankful for us all, she found a lot of things to do that are very effective. And we'll be talking about those, the treatment things, in the third talk. But, you know, her son, he had it at an early age, had it young. And her family, actually, the particular disease they had was a combination of central and peripheral vision loss. So it was sort of a combination of macular degeneration and Stargardt disease, sort of the worst of both worlds. But the thing really, the bottom line here is to remember that these diseases are more similar than they are different. And so the treatments that we're going to talk about apply to all of these diseases. The research applies really to all of these diseases. If you have retinitis pigmentosa and you see an article about macular degeneration, read it, because it's going to be relevant to you.
So the tests, it sounds like there is tests that you can have to see if you have the gene. I mean, is that worth doing? Or?
But no, you know, that one of the really exciting parts of medicine now is something called epigenetics. Epi is a Greek prefix that means on top of. So it's the information on top of your genetics. So you do a genetic test, it's just going to look at your DNA sequence, the sequence of base pairs in your DNA. But that DNA is all wrapped up in these very complex proteins and histones and all kinds of things that shape it, control it, how it folds, what gets expressed on the genome, what doesn't get expressed. And that's only just beginning to be understood. But it's clear that you can have very abnormal genes that never get expressed. And why they would get expressed later in your life and not expressed earlier in your life. There's just a whole world of information here that nobody really understands. But what's clear is that your genes are not your destiny. I don't care what they say you have on a gene test, it doesn't mean you're going to get that disease. And this is true, I don't care whether you're talking about kinds of cancer or degenerative diseases in the eye or metabolic diseases like diabetes. These tests are, they promote a lot of fear. They don't give you knowledge that's really going to help you. And if you want to keep your vision and you've got the gene for one of these diseases, you've got to do the things we're going to be talking about to take care of your health, real basic stuff to take care of your health, because that's what's going to keep you healthy. That's what's going to keep you from getting these diseases. That's what's going to allow you to go to your grave with good vision.
So I guess we're going to hear about that in the next...
Oh, there'll be more, yeah.
Ah, yes. So thank you so much for joining us. This is just part one of three installments, and we'll continue next time.
And I just want to throw in here, you know, Carlisle and I just published a book called Stem Cells Heal Your Eyes. Okay. It is available on Amazon.com, Stem Cells Heal Your Eyes. It's a great book, and it really lays out all of this information we're going to be talking about here. So if you want to know more, go get that book. You'll love it.
Have a good one. Talk to you soon, and keep looking out for new episodes.
Thank you.